Yes, A-League Kickoff Round 5, Nick Butler alongside the American Samoa destroyer, the man that potted 13 goals in 2001. Archie Thompson, great to have you.
Yeah, well, it's actually 20 years this year anniversary since that game, and unfortunately I would have loved to have gone over and done something with him because I reckon there's still a few of them that maybe have nightmares about me.
There's a few of them that have recently turned 30. There was a couple of teenagers playing that.
Mate, what does that say for me then if they're turning 30?
A couple of questions on the 13. I love the 13.
Yeah.
Where does that sit in the many great things you did in your career?
Yeah, well, look, when I scored 13 goals, I actually went overseas to Belgium. And, you know, they thought that I was going to be scoring 13 goals every week.
It looked good on paper.
It looked good on paper, but when you actually put it into reality, they went, it pretty much sucked. And then I got copped a lot from it. But, you know, I've still got a world record, people.
So. Do you want to get... Should our show's growing. We're getting some budget. Should our people talk to the American Samoan people and we do an OB and you go and take a clinic and we'll take you back there? Because I think they like you, or do they hate you like Adelaide?
Well, look, I don't know. But I did tell you Adelaide were going to lose.
You did.
And they did. And yes, thank you. Well done, victory. But look, I'd love to go back there, man. We should do something. Your people, talk to my people and talk to the people that have money to do it.
We'll do that. Speaking of people, we are sort of lighting up the Twitter ratings. We started the show. We didn't know how we're going to go, but people went on and people are watching. And Homicide Williams, Corey, the man you did the shout out to with the glasses last week, he wants some airtime and he's beamed in to say g'day.
Yo, Archie, what's up, man? This ain't a cupcake league. Let's get on this show together, man. I think talking A-League, talking NBL right now, it's a great topic. It's a great time for basketball in this country. And I think you and I on the show, it'll be a hit. I don't even think I know that shit. So let's get it together, man. All right? Peace.
I think we probably should have beat the old... he's a good slow talker, Homicide, isn't he? Very direct
mate,
to the
I'll
camera.
Tell you what,
and he wants airtime.
When he was speaking and that soft, soothe, smooth American voice, my buttons just were coming undone. Slowly just popping away. So, look, he's a smooth character. I'd love, obviously, to do some stuff with
him. This is not Kickoff After Dark era. But Homicide doing great things in the basketball on 10 Peaks. So it's all in the 10 family, and we love you, Homicide. So thanks for that.
Do.
We better hook into some football because it's a good round, round 5. Western United v Adelaide United. I want to start with Western United. We picked Johnny Aloisi, had a strut. Yeah. Then it turned into a cartwheel. He will be leading a marching band into Amy Park on Friday because they've had 3 wins in a row. Gone beautifully.
They are killing it. And I don't know if you've seen some of the matches, but there's one big defender in there called Lacroix.
Yep.
Now, I know there's 7 wonders of the world.
Yeah.
This guy is 8. The 8th wonder of the world, mate, because he stands this tall, this big, and he's a beast and a great defender. Unfortunately, he didn't play on that game.
No.
We had Topper Stanley, a good mate of mine, that came in, fitted well into that side, but they are doing some amazing things. But one player that I feel like is probably underrated, when you look at, you know, talking about Diamante and all these other players, Kilkenny.
Yep.
Kilkenny in the midfield, he's come from Perth Glory. I tell you what, they'd love him back because he's been outstanding for Western United.
One more on Western United because I've got a couple on Adelaide United who are struggling a bit and need some points. The last time Johnny, when he was with Brisbane, faced Adelaide United, there was a bit of knuckle in the tunnel.
Yes.
So, and Ross was involved, and Ross is fiery, but there'll be some feeling in this because there was a scuffle. I'm sure we've got the pictures and it was a big deal. So the emotions will be high on Friday night.
Well, look, I don't know with your family, but my family, there's always one brother that's cool and calm and collective.
That's
and then there's another brother that's a wild animal. So there's a beast underneath him and it comes out.
That's Ross.
You know, and that's Ross. And look, I think there'll be some, there'll be a bit of fire because Adelaide want to kick their season off. They haven't really kicked their season off yet.
They're no points from 4. Mm. I heard Craig Goodwin speak after the game. He was trying to be positive. Hey, we're going okay. It's not that bad. We're not finishing front third, that sort of stuff. At what point do you go, hang on, we need some points, and you start to clam up, and then it gets a bit testy in the meetings, and confidence drops, and it gets a bit selfish. Yeah. They're not there yet, but I fear they could get there.
Well, look, they've still got the quality there. One thing that I did talk about that game over the weekend against Melbourne Victory was that Cassini Yenge quality player. Like, he's young, he's up and coming, and you don't want to take that, I guess that unpredictability out of his game, but you still want him to have a bit of awareness of what's going on. And sometimes when you're young, you just want to do everything. I did say that, kids think that they can walk on water, but unfortunately, you sink.
Man's got to know his limitations.
Unless you're Homicide Williams, that man walks on water, 100%.
Give us a tip. Can Adelaide win on the road?
No, I don't think they can. I think that West United are too strong. They're starting to hit their straps, full of confidence, and again, playing at home.
I think you're scared of the Aloisis. Hey, Central Coast, Western Sydney, big game for a few reasons, yeah. But poor old Carl Robinson, he is under the pup. Hashtags, getting booed.
Yes.
Can you get back from there? Because they're turning on him.
Look, it's hard because he's been in this position before, and they've got an amazing squad. And for the life of me, for so many seasons, I don't know why anybody can't get him clicking. And usually it's down to the playing group too, but manager is a big part of that. And unfortunately, we're not seeing it happen this year, but it's got to turn around. And I'll tell you what, if Carl Robinson isn't on the blower to Santa Claus and saying, you know what, Santa, please give me 3 points.
He seems like a ripping guy. Articulate. He's modern in the fact he talks about growth and challenges for individuals. He's not an old school coach. I don't think he rants and raves and that sort of thing. So how much time do you give him? To get it right, get some points.
Well, I had the guy just say 1 minute, so I don't know if he's saying he needs 1 minute. He probably just needs to get a couple of wins, and hopefully that can turn everything around for him.
Okay, let's rip into the Derby.
He's not going to do it against Central Coast because they're good.
Good. Melbourne City, Melbourne victory. Well, we had a big game. We talked original rivalry this week. What about the Derby? You would have played in a few. How does it compare?
Well, I don't know if you can see this, right?
So getting mobile.
I'm getting mobile, right?
You want the glasses?
I should, actually. Yeah, I've got to put this on. So I don't know for people at home that know my celebration, but Melbourne City players...
Like Tom Cruise. Look at Maverick.
Melbourne City know my celebration too well because I've scored so many times against them. So for all the City fans out there, that's what's happening right now.
Ooh,
you remember that because victory are going to come for you. Even though I love the way that City play. I love the way City play.
Yeah.
But Melbourne victory, they're on fire.
It should be a nice game of football. Victory confidence up now. Great away win.
I don't know why I went there, mate.
I liked it. I liked it. It was very essential. They're away fans. Commitment. I love that there were no phones in the crowd. They were in the moment.
Yeah.
All of that sort of stuff. So they're going to be feeling good. Melbourne City's a talented team.
Yes.
Quickly, we are getting the wine. Give us a tippy. How does it play out?
Oh, well, look,
and take head, not heart.
Okay, well, look, I think... that stadium's going to be pumping. There's no doubt about it. That's going to be full. Probably one of the closest games we've seen in a long time. I just think Melbourne victory.
Okay.
Yeah, I do.
We're going to get abuse on the Twitter. Brisbane Roar, Perth Glory. I feel sorry for Warren Moon. We've gone in for Warren every week. Are we going to see some Sturridge? I think we are, finally.
Yeah.
He doesn't want to do a U after the 13 and just not quite live up to the hype.
Mate, look, I don't care. I just want to see him. I just want to see him out there playing. Perth, again, need to kickstart their season. They had a great little run here in Melbourne where, you know, they could have done a little bit better with City, copped a last-minute goal, which could have changed what they need to do in Brisbane. But Brisbane, they need to start converting. And they're at home, so I think they might be just a little bit strong for Perth.
Yeah, proud club. Hopefully they can get the points. Macarthur, Newcastle, good game. The Bulls on fire. How does it play?
Well, look, I love Newey. I just think that what they did...
Yule, you love Yule.
Yule. I don't know Yule. But Mikel Tadzi.
Yeah.
Now, if I got that right, please. I'm probably going to get a bit of abuse for that for getting it wrong. But he scored a double on the weekend. Peña... Brazilian, outstanding. I just think Newcastle, too good.
Okay, that'd be an upset.
Yep.
And Sydney FC, the Phoenix. I'll tell you what, the Phoenix are homesick. They've been right off their tucker. They need to get home.
Yeah.
Sydney FC's a story. Yep. Stevie Corriker has gone transfer window. He's talking transfer to big-name players. Is it too early to play that card? Because if that backfires, Arch, that's done. You've alienated your best players.
Well, look, I think they're old enough, ugly enough to know that their performances haven't been fantastic this year. And, you know, Steve Corica, he's close with the playing group.
Yeah.
He knows how to get the best out of it. There's a respect on both sides. So I think they'll turn their season around. But, again, Wellington, they had a good win during the week, FFA Cup. So
form builder.
Form builder. So it'll be a close one, but I just think Sydney. I do think Sydney.
They need it. They're a proud couple of Sky Blues. We can't have them sitting down below. Hey, that is round five. Yep. I reckon there might have been a little bit too much fluff from us and enough sprout, but we enjoyed it. So that's the round five kickoff. Enjoy all your football all weekend on 10 and, of course, Paramount+.